Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to day two of the Tech and Innovation Summit 2021. In this session, we will have a keynote address by Prakash Kumar, who's co-founder and CTO of Cartmax. And the topic of his keynote will be how tech is turning D2C businesses more efficient and profitable. Prakash is a techpreneur, co-founder and principal architect of Cartmax and enterprise-grade headless e-commerce platform. He is also CTO at Green Honchos, a leading e-commerce solutions company where he led tech implementation for 50-plus D2C brands from India and Western countries. Thank you, Prakash, for joining us, and over to you.
Profitability is elusive for many of the D2C businesses today. As per some industry reports, nearly 98% of D2C businesses find it very difficult to become profitable when they sell through their own website or app. While the e-commerce industry has been in India for nearly two decades, how the industry leaders or the marketplaces are not profitable yet. They are primarily investing into product, sales, marketing, customers' post-order experience, and operations efficiency. Now, while brands are selling the same products everywhere, be it at the marketplace or at their own channel, the marketplaces are actually doing a better job in the other four buckets. And this is where technology can help. Hi, I am Prakash Kumar, the co-founder and product architect of Cartmax, an enterprise-grade e-commerce platform. I'm also the CTO of Green Honchos, a leading D2C enabler for nearly a decade. In this power-packed session, we'll talk about seven specific areas where you can leverage technology to make your business more resilient, efficient, and competitive. So we'll talk about the infamous dilemma about build versus buy and what is the right option for you. We'll also talk about monolithic versus headless architecture. We'll also talk about how do you know if you are overspending on technology or underspending? What is that magical figure for your business? And how do you know if you have adopted the right D2C technology that is good enough for your team to run it? We'll also talk about whose advice do you trust, right? Not every company has the same talent pool, and hope your business is not limited because it couldn't afford hiring the top talent. I promise I will keep it quick, so let's start. Okay. So when the question comes about build versus buy, our advice to most of the businesses is go for the second option, and that is buy instead of building it from scratch. Because these D2C businesses, most of these D2C businesses are not built to really, you know, develop and maintain technology, right? Because once you go into that loop of building the software, then yes, you know, basically it opens a Pandora's box for most of the businesses. So all of it creates a loop where you are on a constant circle in a loop of, you know, developing the software. You need to worry about its upkeep and maintenance. You need to battle attrition. You will need to keep your software relevant over the course of years. And the problem is, whatever is cutting edge today may become obsolete very soon, within a few years. Okay, so you will have to continuously remain invested into that build option. On the other option, if you go with the buy option, and in simplest terms, if you can go for, you know, if you subscribe for any SaaS services, okay, then two things happen. One, you need not to bother about all the headaches that comes with, you know, the build and the maintenance of the software. One, your management focus bandwidth is, you know, is reserved for the task that you really want to do, and that is your actual product development and its marketing. And the second, your cost becomes predictable. Most of the SaaS platforms actually charge you a per transaction basis, or consider, you know, a part of your revenue in a revenue share model. So that keeps your cost predictable into technology, and that is the biggest benefit that you get when you go for the buy option. Most of the popular CMSs that you hear out there, the off-the-shelf CMSs, likes of Magento, WooCommerce, OpenCart, PrestaShop, etc. These are actually the examples of monolithic piece of software. Why monolithic? Because a single piece of software is taking care of almost every parts of your platform, whether it is your catalog management or it is your cart and checkout experience, customer's My Account experience, or your admin panel. Okay, each of it is taken care of by a single piece of software and it is connected to a single database. Okay, that creates a major problem. In fact, we had experienced it firsthand. In 2018, we were working with one of the large brands in India, and they had like 550 plus stores across India, and they wanted to implement their omni-channel solution. So basically, they wanted to mobilize the inventory across all their stores for their online customers and vice versa. They were already live with their e-com website, and it was on one of the popular CMSs. The website was just not stable. Okay, they had asked us to help with maintaining that website and just to scale it up for a really bigger marketing campaign. But given the nature of it, that CMS. But there were just too many plugins installed there, and there were just too many custom code bases out there, and almost every piece of plugin had access to the entire platform, and they could influence any plugin could influence any part of the website. It was very complicated, so we broke it down into smaller modules, and we gave each of the modules a single responsibility, and it was hosted and maintained independent of the other modules. So that single responsibility module really worked well, and we were able to scale the website to almost like 20x or 25x of the traffic that they were experiencing earlier. So in fact, I do remember that once we had broken down all the modules, and actually it was the headless architecture, then the sales had resulted into almost like a 40% jump overnight. Okay, and we were pretty excited with the success of this this new architecture, and this is that is how the CartMax was born, and we later developed it. So if the question comes of building the software in-house, I suggest you speak to your developers and talk about headless architecture. There are so many, every businesses has just so many data points that are being generated every day, every minute, every hour, okay, that you need to ingest, analyze, and basis that form some opinion or take some action. So technology can help you maintain some consistency here, okay. It can help you bridge that knowledge gap. At CartMax, we have developed a virtual assistant that leverages the power of machine learning and artificial intelligence, and which is able to ingest 300 plus data points in your business from across multiple departments and different events, and it is able to analyze it, and then it is able to give you a very coherent picture of how your business is doing. Okay, and the better part is, if you ask it, it can also take some actions. So let's see an example.
Hi, Prakash.
Hi, Max.
Hi, Prakash. How do you do?
I'm doing good. How is the sales going?
Looks good so far. You have received 6,820 orders with total revenue of 6.1 crore in the last 7 days. However, the RTO has increased to 25% in this period, against our average monthly RTO of 18%.
Can you figure out a reason for this high RTO?
Okay, I found these. 62% of RTOs have come from Maharashtra in the past 7 days. I also see the PIN code serviceability list was not updated in this period. There has also been some delayed dispatches reported that you may want to check back with the warehouse people.
Okay.
Would you like to ask Vishal, the operations head, to check it with the logistics partners?
Yes.
Okay, I have sent an email to Vishal and I have copied you on the email too.
Okay, sounds good. Thanks.
Thanks. Have a nice day.
So what resources do you need to maintain your e-commerce website? Do you need to maintain a team of developers to run it? Like, do you need a developer? Do you need a UI developer? Do you need a theme builder? Okay, what sort of resources do you need? Okay, see, over the course of years, the software have become so easy to use and so intuitive that usually you do not require very high tech skills to play with it, to operate it, right? Primarily because the software have become so intuitive to use that you do not need any specialized skill to run these pieces of software. And so has been the case of e-commerce websites as well. So if you need to maintain a team of developers just to keep your website going, then perhaps you should evaluate your options. So I will give you a very short demo of how easy it has become to build your e-commerce website. Okay, you just do not need any technical skills. If you are familiar with Word, Excel, PowerPoints, if you can just drag and drop simple things, then that is all the skills that you need. Okay, so you have to be on a relentless quest to make your business more efficient with whatever resources you have. And the good news is technology can help you there. So the bottom line is kill the inefficiency before it kills your business. Now, everything that we have discussed today in this session, we have put it in a single document for your easy reference, and it is available at cartmax.in/efficiency. Thank you.
So with the boom in B2C, do you see a lot of scope for many India-focused e-commerce builder startups, like the likes of Shopify?
Right. So Shopify, yes, they are focusing into the India market too now, but I think they have got a little late because there are a number of India-specific problems that are not solved yet, right?
Mm, okay.
So, for example, most of these D2C builders were actually built from scratch in the Western market, right? Therefore, many of the India specific use cases are not solved by them yet. For example, one very common use case is that in India the people are not very email friendly, but in order to do any transaction at each of these sites, they actually force you to share your email address and then create your account and then complete that transaction. So that is not very user friendly. I mean, think of the higher age groups and the elderly people, right? So these solutions are still on a journey to solve for a number of India specific use cases. Yes, we have solved such use cases at CartMax as well.
Okay, all right. The next question is, what is more important for D2C businesses? Logistics, easy returns, or payments?
I think we can't pick and choose one of these two. Both are equally important because it is very important to give your customers a very seamless experience. So logistics is important. And at the same time, the automated handling of a return or refund is also equally important, right? So actually, your customers are expecting the same level of of experience that these marketplaces are giving them already, right? So D2C brands can't be behind that. while you know when they are serving the customers through their own channel. You need to meet the expectation that is already set by, or the benchmark already set by, the marketplaces.
So ultimately, it is the customer experience that needs to be done now. Your easy returns, payments, everything has to make the customer experience supreme, I would say.
Right.
The other question that we have got is that in terms of technology, what is missing in India's D2C despite the boom? Despite the boom in D2C, what in terms of technology, do you think anything is still, any piece is still missing and needs to be kind of plugged?
Right. See, for most of the D2C brands, whenever they start their e-com journey, and when they deliberate over the technology that they want for their platform, one question definitely comes, and that is build versus buy. Whether you should build it in-house from scratch or using some off-the-shelf software, or should you just buy or rent a already hosted platform like Shopify? Okay. So as a rule of the thumb, the buy option works for most of the businesses, okay, because you do not want to invest into technology, because that investment, once you invest into the technology to build your application, then you will have to remain invested in it for a very long period of time, right? So and that will also use up your management bandwidth, your focus bandwidth, right? So usually the buy option is the best. Go for SaaS. And second, whenever you are evaluating any of these platforms, whether it is off-the-shelf, self-hosted applications like Magento or WooCommerce, etc., or whether it is SaaS, just think if it is headless or not, right? Because the current architecture of at least the self-hosted applications, it was built like a decade and a half ago, right? So we call it the legacy architecture. Now, in e-commerce, there are just too many moving pieces in terms of technology. Okay, and these need to be separated from each other. So, speak to your developer about the headless architecture if they can build it on that. Later, it will save you a lot of headache into when you would really want to scale your business.
And I think with SaaS coming in and the cost going down, it's become much easier now, would you say so?
Yes, agree to that.
Okay. All right, Prakash, thank you so much for being with us here today. It was a pleasure to host you. And as you said that, it's a journey for D2C and other businesses. And if one can build a headless sort of architecture, because that is easier going forward, and we have to chuck legacy and start from the scratch. That's what I think is the crux of your talk today. Thank you so much for joining us here, and thank you, audience, for being here. And
thank you.
Thank you, Prakash.